At low tide, a causeway provides access to the holy isle of Lindisfarne. The name Lindisfarne was given to the island by the first Anglo-Saxons to live here. Saint Aidan, from the Scottish Isle of Iona, established the first monastery here in 635.
The shape of these fishing huts, something like an overturned longboat, reminds us of the Viking history of the Holy Island. One of the highlights of the Christian influence on the development of the English language is the production of illuminated manuscripts. And one of the most famous, the Lindisfarne Gospels, was created here at the Priory of Lindisfarne on Holy Island. The Lindisfarne Gospels consist of the books of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Was produced in the late 7th, early 8th century, and it's illustrated in a style that mixes both the Celtic and the Anglo-Saxon styles. It's believed that the Lindisfarne Gospels were produced in honor of St. Cuthbert. The British Library's virtual book section will allow you to turn the pages of the actual Lindisfarne Gospels. In the late 8th century, the priory at Lindisfarne was attacked and destroyed by Viking raiders. The Anglo-Saxon Chronicle records the event in 793. In the year, fierce foreboding omens came over the land of Northumbria. There were excessive whirlwinds, lightning storms, and fiery dragons were seen flying in the sky. These signs were followed by great famine, and on January the 8th, the ravaging of heathen men destroyed God's church at Lindisfarne.
In the museum at Lindisfarne Priory is this round-topped stone that archaeologists believe is a grave marker. It may even have marked the grave of someone killed in one of the Viking raids on Lindisfarne. On one side, we have traditional Christian symbols, but on the other side is carved a line of Viking warriors with their weapons raised over their heads.
Lindisfarne wasn't the first Viking raid on England. Like the Anglo-Saxons before them, the Vikings first came in raiding parties and then later came and settled. Soon we had people of Viking descent living side by side with people of Anglo-Saxon descent. The languages mixed, and although the Vikings' language enriched the English language with many words of Norse origin, it was the Anglo-Saxon Old English language that persevered.